Hello everybody and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today we're doing a Dark retries on an older DLC that I've previously checked out on Dark Tries. So as you probably saw from the thumbnail, we are going to be looking at this. This is the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway, Stroudly A1 and A1X 060 tank engine brought to Train Simulator by Victory Works. So, what are the A1s and A1Xs? These were a class of small tank engine designed by William Stroudly for the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway. 50 examples of the A1 class were built at Brighton Works between 1872 and 1880, with 17 members of the class later being rebuilt into the A1X specification, which gave them a bit more power. There was a lot of variation among the class, and they were nicknamed Terriers due to their small size, loud bark, and surprising power for their size. These engines got around all over the place, with examples being seen not only on the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway, but of the pre-grouping companies, the Southeastern and Chatham Railway, and the London and South Western Railway, with a later example actually ending up on the Great Western Railway during its later life. These engines also operated for the Isle of Wight Railways, several of which ended up on the Isle of Wight for some of their pre-grouping companies and into the grouping Southern Railway. Some members of the class also ended up on other light railways such as the Kent and East Sussex Railway, and these engines were quite handy. They were very small, very light, and could do quite a lot considering their small size. So they were quite handy for the Southern Railway and all of the other railways that required light engines in the south of England. And also the southwest, funnily enough, with the Great Western. So these engines continued to operate into Southern Railway days, having taken part in the First World War. They also operated through the Second World War and passed into nationalisation with British Railways. These engines ended their lives either on the Isle of Wight Railways or on small branch lines with light railways over on the mainland. They were all gone by 1963, with 10 members of the class being preserved across England and also in Canada, because there is a member of the class over in Canada. So that is a brief history on the A1 and A1X Terriers. So what we're going to do now is we're going to have a flyby of some of the liveries that are included with the bundle add-on packs, because there is a base pack for the Victory Works A1 and A1X. Then there are an add-on pack that adds quite a few other variations in, so we're just going to be looking at all of the ones that I've got. So without further ado, let's have a look at these liveries and variants included with the pack before we go for a little drive with one of the Terriers. So, just before we get started looking at the liveries and variants included with these packs, I would advise people to go and have a look at the original Dark Tries that I did on the Victory Works A1 and A1X class. That should be in the description below, or there should be a card at the top of your screen now, just so you get some extra background context and you can see what the differences are with a fresh set of eyes and a fresh computer here in 2024 as compared to when I covered the class originally. So we're going to begin here with the first livery that we are probably all familiar with. This is an A1 class locomotive in London, Brighton and South Coast Railway, in quotation marks, improved engine green. Now, I'm not sure whether we're looking at the same thing or not, but to me, this locomotive is overwhelmingly yellow. Now, I know there's some green lining and there's obviously the red frames and the coupling rods, but that is a yellow locomotive. Now, I'm not sure whether the improved engine green refers to the green lining around the tanks and the front of the splashers there, or whether it's the rumour. I will point out this is a rumour that Stroudly was slightly colourblind and didn't realise that this was yellow rather than green. You can argue amongst yourselves in the comments section about that one. But what we're looking at is the locomotive as they would have originally been seen in this London, Brighton and South Coast livery. Now, this version is Bookham, but everybody probably knows this livery for Stepney, number 55, which is obviously famous for being on the Bluebell Railway, and also famous from the Railway Series books and Thomas the Tank Engine TV show. Now, I decided not to put Stepney down because that's just the kind of guy I am. So we're going to have a look at this. We're going to have a scoot around. There will be some lag because of the amount of other locos in the scenario. But essentially, I would say that here in 2024, Victory Works' modelling still holds up with the A1 and A1X Terriers. So we're going to start orbiting around. You can see that the main difference between an A1 and A1X will be pretty obvious with the pipes that come from the smoke box down to the tanks. And you've also got lots of customizability and variation included with these locomotives. Victory Works kindly have supplied a program that can do that, their number generator. So you can customize these with all sorts of things. You can have different bunker types, including with and without the toolbox, with and without the extensions up to the top of the, up above the bunker. So that sort of includes a bit extra coal capacity. Or you can have the Isle of Wight style extended coal bunker. There's also variations on chimneys, variations on, of course, the brasswork. There's also dome changes as well, and also some different whistles as well. And with these earlier versions that you can see has the names on the sides of the tanks, you can actually customly name those. So if you want to name it something else, you physically can. That's the amount of customizability we're talking about. So even though this is a slightly older DLC, the fact that there is so much customizability, slightly complex customizability, I might add, because it's all to do with letters and numbers in the locomotive number string. But again, there is a program that can help you out with that, which is an external program developed by Victory Works in order to be able to do that. So that is a look at the first livery and the A1. So that is a sort of brief overview of what the customizability is. We'll have a look at some of those as we keep mooching around. So the next livery we're going to look at, if I can scooch the camera over, I do apologize if my camera movements are not smooth, but this is Marsh Umber. So this is the later version of the London Brighton and South Coast Railway livery. As you can see, this one is named Thames, and this is number 6, I think it's 657. So these ones, you can obviously rename them like you can with the improved engine green, but I think you can also have the London Brighton and South Coast Railway livery, you know, the logo on the side of the tanks, or you can have the London Brighton ampersand South Coast Railway livery on the side. So I know I'm saying livery, I mean logo, you know what I mean. So I'm actually not that thrilled with this particular livery. I think it's sort of more of a brown livery. It's fine and it's well done and represented pretty well. It's also got a little bit of, I think, purple in there as well. But we'll just scooch around so everybody can have a look. This one obviously just has the plain original bunker there, and it is number 657, that's correct. You can also see that it's got the air pump on the side there. You can also see that it's got the regular style dome, and it's got a regular style chimney with the brass work all done. Again, texture-wise, I think that these still hold up here in 2024. It will vary depending on your... depending on your graphic settings, of course. But, you know, I still think that even though we've only seen two liveries, that's still quite a lot of variation considering that before these came around, we only had some freeware Terrier to look at. And they were only, I think, in Southern Railway livery for the old Isle of Wight route. So, as I mentioned earlier on, these things got around a lot. And as you can probably tell, just by scooching back over here with all that lag, there is a lot of variations and liveries to look at. So, obviously, they didn't just work for the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway. They also worked for the Southeastern and Chatham Railway. So here is number 751 in the lovely Southeastern and Chatham Railway lined green. And it's sort of a very pale looking green, I will admit. I think that really this could do with a little bit of an improvement in the modern times. But it still looks good. And it legitimately means that you can use these Terriers on any of the pre-grouping Southern era sort of areas. So you can use it on London Brighton, Southeastern and Chatham, and as you'll see in a minute, the London and Southwestern. So again, this one has the brass work on the chimney and on the, I think it's either a condenser or part of the injector. It's got the regular dome, and as you saw at the back, it's got the regular bunker. So this is basically one of the bog standard A1s. So that's in SECR livery. Next to it is also SECR livery, but this one is the wartime grey livery from World War One. So this one, obviously, you can use during a World War One style scenario. And if I just move along to the back, you can see one of the first major bits of variation, which is that you've got the coal rails on the bunker to help hold in coal, which is obviously lacking on the previous version. There's also a version where you've got the, I think they're called louvers, but where they basically have hatched in all those bits so that the bunker is higher and you can hold more coal. You've also got, as you will see in a moment, a slightly extended bunker, which would have been used mostly on the Isle of Wight railways, but not necessarily always. So again, this is the South Eastern and Chatham Railway Grey livery from World War One. It's also still got the bell whistles. I think it's mainly the Isle of Wight locos that would have had hooters, which was standard for the Isle of Wight railways. Next to it is one of my favourite liveries, and not because I'm actually, no, that's a lie. I am very biased because I am a London South Western Railway man. But this is the London and South Western Railway lined green with the sort of brown lining. You can see here that the brass work is gone from the chimney. And you can also see that this is the first time we see a different dome. Now this one has a Drummond style dome. So, and the black roof as well, because most of them previously have had white roofs apart from the grey one. So that's another variation you can do. And I believe this one has the regular style bunker. Number 735 there. I'd say that this could be improved nowadays texture-wise, because this isn't really London and South Western. This is more like a really lime green. It could do with a bit of a texture update at some point, potentially. But as far as representing a variation of the class, it serves its purpose quite well. And it's also quite a niche one, because I believe only one class member went to the SECR and one went to the London and South Western Railway. I'm happy to be corrected in the comments, by the way. I'm not against that, because we all know that I don't like spreading misinformation. I'm going by what I can see and what I can gather from my limited research on the matter. But those are the sort of like mainland liveries, I guess you'd call them, for the pre-grouping. Now, if we move over here, we've actually got the livery that I find is my favourite of the sort of early liveries, which is actually for the Isle of Wight Railways now. Now, this is the Freshport, Yarmouth and Newport green, and I really like this livery. I think the green pops a little bit better than the London and South Western Railway one. And, of course, being an Isle of Wight locomotive, I believe this one has the extended bunker. You can also see, as we scooch round, that it has a regular dome, regular chimney. It's still the A1 version, and it's got the black pump there. But it's also got, as you can tell, the extended bunkers that were more common on the Isle of Wight. And it's also got the red coupling rods, and it's got the black on the back of the cab. So we scooch around there. You can basically just see that I just like this livery, to be perfectly honest with you. I think it's a really pleasant livery. So the next one next to it is the Isle of Wight Central Railway livery, which is black with red lining. And this one has the addition of a headboard. I believe you can put different headboards on this version. So those are the first two of the Isle of Wight livery ones. I believe they're actually the only major Isle of Wight railway liveries on there. So these would have been the pre-grouping companies of the Isle of Wight that bought terriers from the mainland. And these, of course, would have been absorbed into the Southern Railway and into the wider Isle of Wight network routes. So now it's time to move on to a few of the oddities over here. Is this livery. This is Brighton Works Weathered. Now, you do get a clean version as well, but you've also got this one, which is the official Brighton Works livery. I believe one of these won an award. I might be mistaken, but I think one of these terriers did win an award. And this one is number DS377. So this would have been the work shunter at Brighton. And I think it's actually, technically speaking, a later livery that the class would have worn, or at least this particular member, because of it being the dedicated shunter in Brighton Works. So there is a clean and a weathered version of it. The weathering is still pretty good. I mean, obviously nowadays we've got better weathering techniques in train sim, but for the time this looked pretty good, and the fact that it's still quite a lot of variation, you can see the sheer amount of variation we've got with this class. You can also see, if we look at the back of the engine, that this is the first of those I call it louvered, but I'm not sure it's louvered. This is basically sort of like the hatched in coal rails. I also did, it has not escaped my notice actually, if we want to look at glitches, that there's a bit of coal sticking out of there. So, very small glitch, I will admit, but it's one I have just noticed on that. It's not the biggest deal in the world, but it's fine. Next up is obviously a livery that I think a lot of people will like. This is Kent and East Sussex Railway Blue, and this is the locomotive Bodiam, which I believe is number 3. Let's see, yeah, Kent and East Sussex Railway number 3. So this one has a very strange variation on the bunker, which is that it's got the bunker, it's got the coal rail, but it hasn't got the toolbox. So again, showing the sheer amount of customizability. I believe you can even change the bunkers on these liveries to give it an extended bunker or the louvered coal rails or whatever. And this one also comes with the addition of a little nameplate. Now, I'm not actually sure whether this is customizable or not. It would be nice to think it is. But either way, you're not going to really want to compare and contrast this one. You're just going to run this as Bodiam. It's just a shame there isn't really a good Kent and East Sussex Railway route in train sim for us to play with this on. But the fact that Victory Works included it, really big bonus in my opinion. And of the last of these sort of interestingly, like sort of, I would say they're sort of pre-grouping, but they're also pre-grouping slash private railway liveries. This is New Haven Harbour Company number 72. And this lining is a little bit less interesting. It's black with just lining around the cab and around the tanks. And you can also see that this has got the regular bunker again with the toolbox. So, I mean, already we haven't even got to the Southern Railway era, and there is an absolute ton of variation in this pack. I believe this is actually, again, the combination of two different packs. Like, you've got the main pack and you've got, like, the early days expansions. But you can pick them up. They're available on Steam Sound Supreme, I believe. Also, there's some on Steam, but I think you're better off getting them from Steam Sound Supreme. So next up, if we scooch right over here, we've got the Southern Railway liveries. So we're now into the 1920s. So this is the darker green of the Southern Railway, and number 2659. And it's basically got the, you know, we've seen the model now, we know what we're expecting from these. You can see, if we look along here, that we've got the different types of bunker all in a row. You've got the louvered one here. I call it louvered, it's not louvered, it's just basically hatched in bunker. You've then got the Isle of Wight style extended bunker, and you've got the coal rail bunker further down. So, basically, this is the Southern Railway green of the mainland. You've then got Southern Railway green for the Isle of Wight. Now, these had a different numbering sequence, so they would have been W and then whatever number they were given. And they were also given nameplates on the Isle of Wight. So you can see there, just along the side of the locomotive, that we have, if we scooch in, number 11 Newport, which I believe is one of the ones that are preserved, actually, which is a nice thing to see. That was kind of by accident, I believe, for me to put that one down, because it's also one of my favourite ones, funnily enough. You can also see this one has the sort of number plate on the back here. And it also still says London, Brighton, South Coast Railway, even though it's Isle of Wight Railway's sort of Southern Railway number 11. So that's sort of the darker greens. Next to it is the slightly lighter shade of olive green. And this is again on an Isle of Wight sort of railways example. And this one is number W4. And this is a very pleasant shade of green. This is the one I like a lot. And you can see here that this must be one of the earlier variations, even though I think it's just random customizability sometimes. But this one is an Isle of Wight liveried one, so with the W, but it has the smaller bunker with coal rail, so that's interesting to see. And then finally, we've got the Southern Railway black ones. So I'm just going to scoot right back to the front here. So this is Southern Railway Bully Black for wartime, and this is obviously a mainland example, number 2650, with the you know, boxed in coal rails, and it's obviously Bullied Sunshine Southern. And next to it, we have this one, which is the Southern Railway Sunshine again, but this is for the locomotives on the Isle of Wight. This is Bembridge, number 14, and this one again has a different bunker, so not every Isle of Wight locomotive would have ended up with the extended bunker, interestingly enough. So, take from that what you will. And then next to this one is this very interesting little fella. Now, I believe that the Great Western Railway ended up buying, I think it was one of these, maybe two. I think it was just the one. But they ended up with one of these for their Portishead Light Railway. And they obviously painted it up in Great Western Railway green in the shirt button livery here. And they also gave it a number on the side of the cab. So this is number 6 on the side of the bunker. And it obviously has the smaller London Brighton South Coast Railway bunker type. And next to it, we have... Oh, there must have been more than one then, because this is number 5, named Portishead. So this is a named version of it. I think you can rename these. I'm sure you can. Somebody will have to check that out with me at some point. But you could legitimately run one of these, and there is actually a Portishead Light Railway route in Train Sim, so actually there is a route that you can run one of these on in the Great Western livery. Or you can just have it on shed in a Great Western shed as a little imposter. So those are the pre-nationalisation liveries. There's a lot to have been covered, is there not? So what we're going to do now is look at the final batch before we go for a little drive. You can see that we've got Stepney there, but we're not interested in that. Because first we're going to have a look at these. So this is the clean British Railway livery. Now there is obviously early and late crest versions, but for the sake of this I've just put down one of each. And I've also continued with the theme of the A1Xs. I believe you've got a couple of, you can put some of the A1Xs into some of these liveries. Not sure whether the A1s A1s you can put in this livery. So as you can tell, this is very OP. It is incredibly overpowered. I'm joking, of course. This is 0P. So this is an engine that was very, very underpowered. But these were still very useful for railways on both the national network and on the Isle of Wight. So this one obviously is number 32650. And these would have been used probably, really all over the place, really. They would have been used on things like the Hayling Island branch, which I intend to do with a terrier at some point. They would have been used, obviously, on the Isle of Wight, the Portishead line, and a lot of the light railways that are around and about in the south of England. So this is obviously the clean British Railways one, and it's really nice, actually. Like, this is actually a really pleasant livery on the terriers, which is interesting, because I'm not normally a fan of black. But line black is good. You can also see the really legible British Railways logo. Victory Works back here really did a really good job with the interiors. Apart from that one very small glitch I found. But, you know, it's really nice to see a nicely done British Railways black. Because next to it we have this one, which is the weathered version of BR Black. And again, this does come in early and late. We've also got the late crest here again with all that weathering. It looks really grubby. Really nice, actually. And again, you saw at the back, you can customize these to have all of the different bunker types. Because I think some of the mainline ones did end up with extended bunkers eventually. So, and I think the ones that were on the Isle of Wight, I'm not sure whether they actually wore BR Black or not. I need to double check that. I think they must have, but I don't think there's a version of them with the Isle of Wight style numbering in BR Black. I'm not sure whether that's a misnomer or whether they just didn't end up working on the Isle of Wight in BR days because they were overtaken by the Adams O2s. So, not bad, not bad at all. There's a lot of variation, a lot of stuff included. And then the final livery we've got here before we move on is this one. There was a bit of knocking in the background. I can't really do anything about that. This is number 55 Stepney. In its original livery that it would have worn over on the Bluebell Railway when first preserved. So, obviously, they couldn't actually call this, like, Stepney with BR liveries. They weren't allowed to have it in BR when they were working on the Bluebell Railway. So they just painted it sort of this unlined black and they called it Stepney. I'm really, really sorry about the knocking in the background. I've been trying to avoid that all morning, but whoever it is, just keep doing it. And I've been really lucky to have gotten to the very last livery for this. So, excuse the knocking that you can probably hear in the background. So that, everybody, is all of the liveries and variants, that most of them anyway, that are included with the A1 and A1X packs. And as you can really see, there is an awful lot of liveries included. Well worth looking into, I think, if you're a fan of Southern Steam or Branch Line Steam or whatnot. So with that being said, we're now going to move over and put a locomotive down because there is something else we need to show in this pack. This pack does come with something else. So we're now going to move over, we're going to pop a locomotive down, and we're going to go for a very short run along part of the Isle of Wight network. So let's go and have a look. So here we are at Newport Station on the Isle of Wight with the train we're going to be taking today. This is going to be a Southern Railway liveried, but Isle of Wight condition, A1X, number 10 cows, with a rake of coaches that are included with the A1 and A1X packs. These are Stroudly four-wheel coaches. So we're going to have a look at those in a moment. But first of all, just to add on to what I was saying in the previous segment, we can actually rename these locomotives. It turns out you can actually rename the Great Western one. So I've renamed this one Terrier, as you can see there. You can rename the Kentley Sussex Railway one. This one I've renamed Dark DJ. I think it has to be six letters on that one though. And of course, the London Brighton South Coach Liveries ones you can rename. This one has been renumbered DDJP. Renumbered? Renamed DDJP. So that is sort of an add-on to what I said previously, which is that those are renameable, which again is incredible variation for the pack. So with that being said, let's have a look at the Stroudly coaches that come with this pack. You have these. So this is a guard and third class compartment. This is a third class compartment coach. This over here is a second class compartment coach. We then have a third and first composite coach. We then have a first class only coach. And at the back, for good measure, we put another third brake. So then, camera views in there, we'll have a look at in a moment. But one thing I want to do first is just for sounds, I wanted to show the difference between the Isle of Wight hooter that is on the loco we're driving today and the bog standard bell whistle that is on the regular Terrier. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to very quickly click on that. We're going to move forward and watch as what was originally Bodium starts spraying steam all over Terrier. But what we're going to do is blow the whistle here so you can have a listen to it. You've also got control space whistles. So those are the whistles that come on the regular version of the engine. Now, if we click on the Isle of Wight engine, and if we go and get up close to it, we will hear the Isle of Wight railway hooters. So here we go. And there you go. So those are the ones I prefer, obviously. But that's up to, you know, you guys. If you guys prefer the whistle on the original version, that's up to you. Or if you prefer the Isle of Wight hooter, that's also up to you. Camera views for the coaches. Unfortunately, you do only get the one in the brake coach, unfortunately. But it's not a bad camera view. You can look out. You can look out to the sides. It's got full 360 range. And you've also got some luggage that you can look at. That was a concerning sound, because that sounded like the train was on the move. But hopefully it's not. Either way, that is the camera view you get from the brake coach at the very least. That glitch is really annoying. There's some asset broken in this room. I'm sure there is. Either way, let's now hop into the cab of number 10 cows. We're going to be going on a short journey shortly, obviously. So what we will do is have a look. So the cab is quite pleasant. It's pretty well textured, to be honest. You've got things such as the reverser there. You've also got the regulator, obviously the firebox down there. You've also got the brake rigging and stuff like that up the top here, which we need to release in a moment. There you go. And then you've got the injector pipe work. You've got the air pump on the side there. And yeah, you can really see that this is a nice little pleasant place to be. I also think this has advanced mode as well. I think Control A does it. There you go. So you can put Control A to put advanced mode on or off. I don't think there's anything for performance, unfortunately. But it's only a small locomotive, so it should be fine. Cab views. We've obviously got this view outside of the cab here. A view on this side of the cab, looking out the window. Down here by the firebox, which I will open up for the massive lag fest that is the firebox. And then we've obviously got up here, back here. So then, we're going to hop out of the cab for a moment and be inside somebody's head. So we can watch the departure of number 10 cows. I'm going to probably be quiet from this point onwards in the video, so we can watch the engine go by and see it doing its work. So for all intents and purposes, for anybody who just wanted to see what variants are included, that's where you can probably stop. At least this is where I'm going to stop talking for now. Well, we have a run with the A1 and A1X Terrier from Victory Works. I hope you all enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoy this little montage of the Terriers running in operation. And I will see you all in the next video. Enjoy the end of this one. Thank you.